Hi friends, welcome once again. In our previous session, we have discussed up to this point. Now first we will discuss osmotic pressure and then its derivation. So write down, osmotic pressure of solutions. Osmotic pressure for solutions. Just for your revision point of view, we know that experimental data, show that the osmotic pressure, pi of a solution is proportional to the concentration of the solute and temperature T. Concentration of the solute and temperature T 1/2 showed that the relationship between the relationship is similar to that for pressure of an ideal gas so for example, for dilute water solutions we can write pi is equal to n by Vm into RT where n is the number of kilomole of the solute and Vm is the volume of pure solvent If I am going to take example of water then, in meter cube associated with n kg mole of solute, and R is the universal gas constant or gas law constant. N is gas law constant 82.057 into 10 is to our minus 3 meter cube atm per kilomole per Kelvin, and T is the temperature in Kelvin. T is the temperature in Kelvin. Note down. If the solution exists as, if a solute exists as two or more ions in solution, then N represents the total number of ions total number of ions. Remember your 11th, 12th class chemistry. One more point. For more concentrated solution, for more concentrated solution, the above equation is modified the above equation is modified modified using the osmotic coefficient phi. Using the osmotic coefficient phi, which is the ratio of the actual osmotic pressure, the actual osmotic pressure phi to the ideal phi calculated from the equation. So for dilute, this value is nearly 1. So for very dilute solution, phi has a value of unity. And usually decreases. As concentration increases. Solve one question. Calculate the osmotic pressure. Of a solution containing 0.10 gram mole NaCl per 1000 gram H2O at 25 degrees Celsius. Given data, density of water (997 kg per meter cube). What will be the answer of this question? Tell me. Remember your 11th, 12th class concept only. Tell me the right answer of this question. Tell me the right answer of this question. The value of N is equal to NaCl. So we have two ions, Na positive, Cl negative. So value of N is equal to 2 into 0.10 into 10 to the power minus 3. 2 into 10 to the power minus 4. Kilomole. The volume of the pure solvent water. The volume of pure solvent water. Density is equal to mass per unit volume. So 1 kg it is 1 kg divided by 997 kg per meter cube. Put the value pi is equal to n by Vm into Rt 2 into 10 is to our minus 4. The value of R 82.057 into 10 is to our minus 3. Temperature 298.15. Vm is 1 divided by 997. And the right answer will be 4.88 ATM. Note down. Note down, write down next. Basic models. For membrane processes. For membrane processes. For the flux equations for reverse osmosis. Actually, we have two basic models. So there are two basic types. Of mass transport mechanism. Two basic type of mass transport mechanisms. Which can take place in membranes. Which can take place in membranes. In the first basic type, using tight membranes. Using tight membranes, which are capable of, retaining solutes, of about 10 angstrom. In size or less. 10 angstrom in size or less. Diffusion type. Transport mainly occurs. And both the solute and solvent. माइग्रेट बाय मॉलिक्यूलर और मॉलिक्यूलर और फिकियन डिफ्यूजन इन पॉलीमर डिफ्यूजन इन पॉलीमर ड्राइवन बाय कंसंट्रेशन ग्रेडियंट सेटअप इन द मेम्ब्रेन सेटअप इन द मेम्ब्रेन by the applied pressure difference by the applied pressure difference by the applied pressure difference second one is loose one in the second basic type in the second basic type using loose or microporous membranes microporous membranes which retain particles larger than 10 angstrom a sieve type mechanism occurs a sieve type mechanism a sieve type mechanism occurs a sieve type mechanism occurs where the solvent moves through the micropores moves through the micropores in essentially viscous flow and the solute molecules and the solute molecules small enough to pass through the pores to pass through the pores are carried by convection with the solvent carried by convection with the solvent so we have basically two types one less than or equal to 10 angstrom and one greater than or larger than 10 angstrom is it clear first one is molecular or Fickian or second one is sieve type mechanism we have already discussed both write down next diffusion type model diffusion type diffusion type model diffusion type model for diffusion type membranes for diffusion type membranes four diffusion type membranes. The steady state equations governing the transport of solvent and solute are to a first approximation as follows. For diffusion of the solvent through the membrane, suppose we have this membrane. Here we have P1, here we have P2, here we have C1, here we have C2. This is our membrane. NW, NS, product permeate solution and fluid concentrate solution. Feed concentrate solution concentration and fluxes in reverse osmosis process this diagram. Draw this diagram first. Then we can write NW is equal to PW divided by LM delta P minus delta pi, or AW is equal to AW into delta P minus delta pi. It means where AW is equal to PW divided by LM. Where NW is the solvent. If we are going to take case of water, flux in kg per meter square per second. EW is the solvent membrane permeability. Solvent membrane permeability. Kg of solvent. Per second per meter per atm. Lm is the membrane thickness. Membrane thickness in meter. Aw is the solvent permeability constant Ag solvent per second per meter square per atm. Next is delta P, that is P1 minus P2, hydrostatic pressure difference with P1 pressure exerted on feed. P1 pressure exerted on feed and P2 on product solution. That is in ATM. Delta pi is equal to pi1 minus pi2. Osmotic pressure of feed. Feed solution minus osmotic pressure of product solution. That is in ATM. This subscript 1 denotes the feed for upstream side of the membrane. And to product or downstream side of the membrane. Diffusion of solvent we have discussed. Now diffusion of solute. For the diffusion of solute. Through the membrane, so the flux of the solute is given by S for solute and S for solute and W for water or solvent. DSKS divided by LM. C1 minus C2 is equal to AS C1 minus C2. So we have AS is equal to DS KS by LM. Air NS is the pollute. Suppose we are going to take case of salt. Pollute flux. In kg of solute per meter square per second. DS is the diffusivity of solute in membrane. Diffusivity of solute in membrane in membrane. In meter square per second, Ks is equal to Cm by C, that is distribution coefficient, that is distribution coefficient is the ratio of concentration of solute in membrane divided by concentration of solute in solution. Concentration of solute in solution Ks is the solute permeability constant. Solute permeability constant. Solute permeability constant. That is meter per second. C1 is solute concentration. Solute concentration in upstream or feed. In upstream or feed, that is concentrate solution. Kg solute per meter cube. C2 is the solute concentration in downstream or product, and our product is, it is permeate, so permeate solution. So kg of solute per meter cube. The distribution coefficient. The distribution coefficient. Ks is approximately constant. Approximately constant. Over the membrane. Over the membrane. Making a material balance making a material balance at steady state for the solute the solute the solute diffusing the membrane diffusing through the membrane must equal the amount of solute leaving the downstream. Or product permeate solution. Permeate solution. So we will get NS is equal to NW into C2 divided by CW2. NS is equal to NW C2 divided by CW2. Where CW2 is the concentration of solvent in stream 2 that is permeate. Ag of solvent per meter cube. Is it clear? Kg of solvent per meter cube. If the stream 2 is dilute in solute, then CW2 is approximately the density of the solvent. The density of the solvent. In reverse osmosis, the solute rejection is defined as the ratio concentration difference across the membrane divided by the bulk concentration on the feed or concentrate side. Means fraction of solute remaining in the feed stream so R is equal to C1 minus C2 divided by C1 or 1 minus C2 by C1. I can correlate this equation with our previous equations, then we will get put the value of NW and NS in this equation from these equations. we have this, we will get ns, and from this equation we will get nw. And then calculate the value of c2 by c1, and then put in this equation. So I am going to write directly final result, r is equal to v into delta p minus delta pi divided by 1 plus b delta p minus delta pi or b is equal to where b is equal to pw ds ks cw2 over aw by as cw2. So unit of b will be atm inverse. So we can say that B is composed of various physical properties PW, DS, KS of the membrane and must be determined experimentally for each membrane. And generally, the value of DS into KS is calculated rather than separately. Note down up to this point. Write down a question. But we need to solve one question and one paragraph about the which one nanofiltration, and then this part will be finished. So this is sufficient for today. So I hope you enjoyed this session also. Thank you very much. Keep learning, keep smiling, be happy. In such a manner, this part is also finished. Bye, take care, and keep revising also. Is it clear up to this point? Very good. Thank you very much.